What up, guys? It's Coach Duran, and today I'm going to talk about the pros and cons of the infighter, aka the swarmer, which many of you have identified with and mentioned in the comments of my other video, the four boxing styles. Some of the great infighter swarmers of all time, if you want to really, some of the best examples, there's many. I just think of Marcus Maidana. I think of Ricky Hatton from Britain, one of my all-time favorite body punchers. You got guys like even Sean Porter, even though he's very versatile, he really does love to be in the close range and rough guys up and maul them. And a lot of Mexican fighters, man. There's so many. Julio Cesar Chavez is the one that comes to mind, but there's many. I want to shout out everybody and express my gratitude to those who bought my course, the Golden Gloves Boxing Course. Check out my website, CoachDuranBoxing.com. And if you've been enjoying these videos, please remember to like and subscribe. All right, so let's get into it. So number one, the infighter, as I mentioned before in my other video, is the most aggressive boxing style. They're constantly coming forward, putting pressure on you, throwing punches in bunches. They're high volume fighters. So they can be very hard to deal with if you don't have the skills and endurance to deal with them. So again, closing the gap, coming forward, they like to carry a high guard, throwing a lot of combinations, they like to go to the body. And then, like I said, they're even willing to take some shots in order to land theirs. Because they know, even if they don't land one or two, they're gonna land something within that storm of punches they're throwing at you. So that's a big plus for them, to getting the momentum in their favor, to stealing rounds with a lot of volume, high volume punching. Number two, they're high endurance fighters. They have great stamina. So if you end up in the ring with one of these guys and your stamina is not up to par, they're gonna expose you real fast. They're high energy, high endurance, again, constantly putting you on the defensive with their combinations, their aggressive style. And this creates what we call a psychological pressure by constantly putting you on the defensive, making you react, blocking, whatever you gotta do, blocking, backpedaling, firing back. By this constant pressure, taking initiative, making you react, putting you on the defensive, it's forcing you to exert more energy and possibly even burn out. You know what I mean? Or take you out of your game at the very least. So these fighters are sharks. They want to take you into deep water and drown you in the later rounds. Number three, they're dangerous in that close range. That's their specialty. That's their comfort zone. That's where they're going to do the most damage, all right? So they're looking for those big uppercuts, those hooks, those liver shots. They're looking for any opening they can get, and they're going to bring the pain. So if your defense is weak on the inside, it's gonna be a long night for you. It's gonna be a rough night. So you gotta learn how to really defend yourself on the inside, but that's when they do their best work. If you are an infighter, that's your thing. You wanna definitely get in there. Look for those openings, touch the body, body, head, head, body. That's what we say in boxing. They're gonna try to bring your guard down and then throw some big shots up top, or they're gonna catch your attention up here with light shots and then dig you to the body. So that's their comfort zone. Some of them who are really good are gonna also take those angles and slide uppercuts up the middle through your guard. They love that. So what are the cons of the swarmer in fighting style? As I mentioned before, because they're so offensively minded, sometimes they forget about their defense and take a lot more punches than necessary. And as I said before, they're even willing to take some punches in order to land their own, because that's their style. They want to overwhelm you, they want to outdo you, they want to outwork you, out-hustle you. Infighters have to remember that the philosophy of boxing is to hit and don't get hit. So if that's your style, always keep that in the back of your mind. Number two, infighters, swarmers, high-pressure fighters are often vulnerable to pot shots. So pot shots are when fighters, you know, they're going to move around. They're going to jump and hit you with single shots often, you know what I mean? Moving side to side and then catching you coming in. So if an infighter or swarmer who's normally running you down, chasing you down, if they don't know how to cut off the ring and take you out of your rhythm first, trust me, you're gonna be eating a lot of pot shots. So a lot of swarmers tend to forget, again, about cutting off the ring, and being very strategic on their way into the inside to do their damage. And they often get pot-shotted and take a lot of punches that they shouldn't have to take. Number three, in-fighter swarmers generally have trouble against slick, fast boxers, counter-punching boxers, guys who are really fast on their feet. Very often we see that in-fighters have problems against these fighters because the in-fighter is like a bull. They want to just charge straight ahead. And it's hard for them to deal with the movement of the slick, fast boxer. In-fighters sometimes like to set their feet before they punch. Not always, but they want to line you up and then shoot you down. But against a slick boxer who knows how to move, who knows how to pivot, who's quick, who's slick, they're able to pot shot these guys. These in-fighters are able to outbox them, counterpunch them, catch them off balance. So in-fighters have to really be aware of that and to, again, have a strategic pathway into that close range before they do their work. So you have to also work on adjusting to the movement of these skilled boxers. So when they don't, you find that in-fighters, swarmers get very frustrated. And once you're frustrated in that ring, you're even more vulnerable to the very slick boxer who's just gonna pick you apart. So in-fighters gotta do their job. Get inside and rough these guys up. That's where they do their best work, on the inside. But to get on the inside, you gotta be very strategic. A lot of double jabs, a lot of feigning, and stuff like that, cutting off the ring. All right, guys, I hope you liked this video, and if so, please remember to like and subscribe, and feel free to share your thoughts on this video in the comments below. And look out for my next video, style number three, the boxer puncher. And lastly, remember to check out my website for more in-depth content, coachdaronboxing.com. And until the next one, see y'all later. Stay blessed.